everybody. I'm glad to be back here again this week to present the children's message. I listened in on Mr. Keith last week talking, and the other week he talked about stories about Jesus at the growing up in the beginning of his ministry. And then Pastor's been talking about public education and how we as Christians can help influence or assist public education. So I thought we'd talk maybe a little bit about education in Jesus's time and tie that in with a Bible story out of Luke chapter 2. Let's talk about differences between your life and the life that Jesus led before he began his ministry. It was over 2,000 years ago. And I'm going to ask you some questions about what was different from now 2,000 years ago. If you remember my last time I talked about showing love and caring for others. So if you're home watching this with younger brothers and sisters or friends, you may know all these answers, so maybe you could give the younger ones a chance to try and answer what they think before you say. And if they say something that's probably not quite right, don't make fun of them. That's a good way of showing that you care. All righty. What kind of clothes do you wear to school? I'm going to pause and let you people at home think about that and shout out answers, kind of like Pastor does sometimes. When I went to school, I had to wear a dress because I was a girl. Even when it was this cold out, I had to wear a dress. That was the rule. By the time my youngest sister was in school, girls could wear pants to school, but not blue jeans. Now I bet most of you answered blue jeans, t-shirts, maybe sweatshirts or hoodies. What do you see? Let me find the right page here. What kind of clothes do you see Jesus wearing and his mom and his dad in this picture? It's not even a dress or dress pants. It's robes, maybe just simple gowns, or I think they called them tunics. How do you think Jesus and his friends learned? They didn't have any elementary or high schools to help them learn. They learned from helping their parents at home and from sitting at the temple, listening to the older people in the temple read the scrolls, which was how their Bible was, listening to others ask questions and what the answers were. Where do you go to school? Maybe you go to a daycare, maybe you go to a preschool or an elementary school. In elementary school, the building's kind of big and there's a lot of rooms and you're probably divided up by age or learning level. So first graders are together, second graders are together, kindergarten is together. Even in preschool, maybe three-year-olds are in one class and four-year-olds are in another class. But like I just said, things were different for Jesus. They learned either from their parents or at the temple, which was their church. Now, there weren't a lot of temples. The way here in town we have many churches. And so it was a good-sized gathering of people. Of course, there weren't as many people then. Or they learned from working with their parents at home, helping with chores. Here's a picture of Jesus, and he's in Joseph's workshop. Remember, Joseph was the earthly father of Jesus, and he was a carpenter. So as he was growing up, Jesus probably learned a lot about being a carpenter. What did their books look like? Has anybody learned? Do you think their books look the same as our books? They had scrolls, which was rolled up, kind of a linen cloth paper, not really like our paper, that the lessons of the Bible, the verses of the Bible, were handwritten. Now, can you imagine how many scrolls and how long it would take? Jesus did not, the New Testament, what we call the New Testament, tells stories after Jesus. But this much of my Bible is called the Old Testament, and that is what was written on these scrolls. If you see how tiny this print is, can you imagine how many scrolls it would take? So not every family had books at home or scrolls at home. Now, you might have at your school a big library that you can go to for books. Maybe at home you have your own bookshelf in your room that you have some of your favorite books on. Or maybe your family has some bookshelves. Maybe you get books once in a while for gifts. I always got two or three new books at Christmas time, and they were some of my favorite gifts. But if everything had to be written by hand and on some very fancy kind of cloth or linen that could be written on by hand, it was group learning. They went to the temple and they learned by listening and asking questions. Now, how do you travel? I think I'm hearing some people say they travel in a van. Maybe some people are saying they went on a train trip one time, or maybe they flew somewhere. Maybe their grandmas or cousins live a long ways away and they travel on an airplane. How do you think Jesus and his family traveled? I'm listening. They did not have cars. They did not have bicycles. They certainly didn't have trains or airplanes 2,000 years ago, when even most of them did not even travel on a donkey. You remember our story at Christmas, Mary is shown riding a donkey to Bethlehem, but that was probably only because she was so close to delivering her baby Jesus. You walked to where you needed to go. And what were the roads like? Well, when you travel in your car or your van and you're on a long trip, you can stop somewhere, use a bathroom, maybe get a snack. Maybe to save money, your family packs a cooler with some sandwiches and some drinks, and you stop somewhere and have a picnic. Well, in Jesus' time, if you're walking, you wouldn't get where you were going very fast if it was very far. And for safety along these dusty roads that didn't have a whole lot of houses or police stations or rest areas along the way, you went as a group. mostly your family or maybe some other people from your village when you would go all the same place. When you have family get-togethers, I don't know how large your family is, but in a lot of families, there's a lot of brothers and sisters and cousins and aunts and uncles. Before COVID, maybe at Christmas time or Thanksgiving, you might have 30 people getting together to celebrate a holiday. And I bet that the older kids tend to go off and do their thing, and the younger kids go off and do their thing. Well, in our story, we're going to hear about a time that the family went to Jerusalem with a whole group of people, and Mary and Joseph lost track of Jesus. I don't know if you've ever been lost. I lost my son one time when he was very little. We were at a big aquarium, it's kind of like a zoo for fish, and I needed to go to the restroom, and I thought my husband was watching my two sons. One was in a stroller, so I know my husband had control of him, but he thought I'd taken my son to the restroom with me, and I thought he was keeping my three-year-old. And when I got out of the bathroom, my three-year-old was not in sight. Sometimes people cover up when they're afraid with anger, and so I started hollering at my husband, how could he have been so careless? And then I started frantically looking for my son. My husband went one way, I went another way. And I just knew he'd gone outside, and so I headed for the outside door, and luckily some kind lady was bringing him back up the escalator. And instead of thanking God that he was safe and giving him hugs and kisses, my fear turned to anger again, and I was like, how could you do this? Why weren't you staying with your dad? Well, that's kind of what happened in our story today. And I'm going to read you from my Bible, Luke 2, chapter 2, verses 41 to 52. And I'm using my bookmark I made last week with those words we're going to try and remember from Advent of hope and peace and joy and love. Every year, his parents went to Jerusalem for the Feast of the Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went up to the feast according to custom. Now, the 12-year-old being 12 is significant because that's when boys were allowed to go with their fathers into the main part of the temple where the other men were discussing, as we talked earlier, what was written on the scrolls and what it all meant. After the feast was over, while his parents were returning home, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. But they didn't realize it. Thinking he was in their group or their company, they traveled on for a whole day. When they began looking for him, again, around their relatives and their friends, no one had seen him. When they did not find him, they went back to Jerusalem to look for him. Now remember, they'd already traveled for a day, so they had to travel for another day to get back. After 3 days, they found him in the temple courts, sitting among the teachers, listening to them, and asking them questions. Can you imagine how worried Mary and Joseph were 3 days of looking for their son? Everyone who heard him was amazed at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astounded. But the mother said, "Son, why have you treated us like this? Your father and I have been anxiously searching for you." Jesus didn't understand this. He answered, "Why were you searching for me? Didn't you know I had to be in my Father's house?" Because Jesus was the Son of God as well as his earthly father, Joseph. But they did not understand what he was saying to them. And he went back to Nazareth with them and was obedient to them. But his mother treasured all these things in her heart, and Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and men. So you could hear that worry turned to kind of anger in what Mary said to him. And like when I lost my son and when they lost Jesus, maybe they forgot to turn to God in prayer and ask and trust that everything would be okay. So there are several lessons we can learn from this story. Now, not everybody's an arts and crafts person, but last time I showed you some things you could do to maybe help you remember the story. So this week, I made some scrolls. And I just used some chopsticks that we'd gotten from some Chinese takeout and a piece of paper and taped it and then just rolled from each way in. But you see those Advent words that I'm really trying hard to remember and to learn to live by as a Christian are on there. Hope and love and joy and peace. And on the other one, I wrote the other big message that I like to remind myself and others about: love God and love others. So those are a couple of simple things you can do if you like to make things to help you remember today's story. Let us say a prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for the gift of your Son and the lessons that we learn through reading your Holy Bible. Open our ears and our hearts and our minds to the teachings of your Son, Jesus. Help us to trust you in our fears and worries, and keep our fears from turning to anger, but celebrate with joy when we get the right answer, or the answer that we think is right. Help us remember those Advent words of hope and love and joy and peace. Help us to have a safe week, especially as we have cold weather and ice and snow coming through. Have a good week. Amen.